Welcome to Auroraboro, a small town bustling with potential. Are you a gregarious ghoulie getting into government? A naughty necromancer in need of some nasty nightlife? A wayward werewolf wandering the west? Whatever you are, whoever you're looking for, you'll find it down the rural roads of Auroraboro.
And we're live. Hello and welcome to Outlaws and Old Ones. I'm your keeper, Jorge. It's very difficult to not say my last name every single time, by the way.
I am Shannon as Remy.
I'm Brian as Robin Renard.
I'm John as the world famous P.T. Sinclair.
And
I'm Emily. I was just going to introduce myself.
I should have trusted you.
Yeah, you really should have. Like, super should have talked about it before. But I was like, oh, fuck, I usually go last. But we have a guest, so I probably shouldn't go last.
Whose name is?
Hi, I'm Emily as Scoot McCutcheon.
That's John's sister. They have a podcast together. John talks about it.
Doing promos now?
She's on as a guest. We got to highlight the thing that she comes.
I was going to wait to the end, I guess.
We
got to
make it a crossover episode. So yeah, it's like,
that would be great. That'd be great if I could do Emily from Downtime with John Downtime Emily.
That's your character that you're playing?
I would love that because then I could just wander around and just do whatever because I truly know nothing.
So go to my apartment. I order a pizza and I fall asleep on the couch.
Two things.
I try to set up for my podcast and it doesn't work. So
two things. We have a good old friend of ours, old as in we've known them a long time.
Old.
Not that they are old.
Ancient.
Evan, who is watching. One, he says cat jam and the jam is in all caps. It says we need cat jam.
I feel like I need cat jam.
It's a
cat jam
emote. It's a Twitch emote.
Oh, I don't even know how I got on here.
Emily's got the cat. Emily, hit us with the cat and the jam.
I thought Oscar like some fan mail for a second.
I thought it was Oscar related as well. But it is also Evan's birthday today.
HBD, Evan.
Birthday. Hippie birthday, dude.
Hot new email.
I already said it. I texted it. I'm not saying it again.
Wow, you don't get another one. You hear that? You hear that, Evan? That's friendship.
You're welcome.
You be thankful for what you get.
Early September birthday is so rough because, like, if you're new in school, then no one comes to your birthday party.
Dude, if you're new in school, it doesn't matter what.
I was going to say.
Just saying, I had a fall birthday, and like it was hard enough after 2 months of kind of sitting next to people to get them to go to your birthday. But maybe, like, hey. Actually, no, you know what? Maybe people just didn't like me.
On second thought,
they were just so lucky.
I also never moved, so they already knew me.
Yeah, I did a mid-year transfer as a child. That's oof, oof.
That's about right.
No good. And now I play tabletop role-playing games online. Great.
That should, yeah.
People can watch you.
Anyways, last time...
What's going on with my puke monster?
We left everybody happily drinking in the bar, and P.T. Sinclair went to relieve himself, and while he was in the stall, if you recall, the puke monster, nice. Back from episode one, I want to say?
I think
did
so.
Yeah.
Sneak up behind him. Covered his mouth so he couldn't scream, and gave him a nice little sniff in the back of the neck. But there's more gurgle to it, right? Because I can't do it because I'm not all puke.
Vomit monster.
But
put some beer in your mouth and.
I assume that he's wearing a hat also for some reason. I think it's because I keep thinking of the Amoeba Boys in Powerpuff Girls.
The Amoeba Boy.
But we'll leave you there alone for now. What about in the bar? We have Robin Renard and Remy McSquemmy drinking at the bar.
Like, I was like, are you waiting for us to tell you? I thought that was your job.
Conrad Hearty is
half the time he is.
He went home. Like, you don't have a home.
He's probably at town hall fucking with the mayor.
Let's not send him there.
No. That seems mean to do.
Where do we want to send him? We do have... We
can... Maybe he, like, passed
we
out
don't,
in the bathroom?
We don't... We are homeless yeah, right now, so I don't know where he would be.
Oh, yeah, then if Remy had to be hung over for an entire day before, then we'll just make Conrad Hearty have drinking too much and passed out at the bar.
At the bar?
Yeah. And, oh,
and no one can move him because he just keeps trying to fight everyone who tries to move him.
He's not small. He's, like, in a corner booth or something.
Yeah, yeah we'll
like,
do corner
we get, just when we get into combat in this bar, he's
downing
out of the
shots
way.
And reciting poetry at people, and then he pulls his gun out whenever somebody tries to say you've had enough. I don't think I have.
I assume he's asleep in the booth with gun in hand, like on his chest.
Eyes completely closed, yet somehow accurately pointing at the people who are threatening him.
Well, let's not have him point guns anywhere because I will make the NPCs kill him. Let's just leave him there and forget about him.
Okay. Yeah, totally different from his regular state of
right. Well, he's passed out drunk.
You're being kinder to him than he is to him.
When
right,
you when so... you do check on him, you do notice that your old pal, well, no, this is your new pal, Scoop McCutcheon, is also drinking in the bar at one of the tables or at the bar? You a bar or
I'm
a table
at the
person?
Bar. I'm a bar person.
Bars where the scoop is.
Yeah.
But a bar is where the scoop is.
Literally.
And also scoop is new in town and alone. So, bar.
Yeah. So, what do bar people do?
Robin will be kind of surprised, but be like, oh, Scoop. Hello. Where did you go?
Oh, hi there. I've just been around, you know, just hanging out at the motel looking for a scoop.
Who's this? You know this lady? She seems cool.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, this is oh wow.
Did I miss something?
Remy McSquemmy, this is Scoop McCutcheon. You were really hungover that one time.
Is that when I slept for a whole day?
It is the entire day.
Word.
Really, we have the fact that we haven't addressed that is pretty amazing. But honestly, we've seen weirder stuff.
Back in the bathroom.
Yeah, am I gonna die?
No, he's so the cool. The puke monster, which let's be honest, it's a he.
That's fine.
Is not attacking you. It's not like trying to drown you with puke.
I'm still like PC Sinclair is going to. He's like in a stall, and
I assumed you were at a urinal.
Okay, cool. So I'm at the urinal, and the vomit slime is behind me.
Yeah. He came behind you, did like a nice little sniff and mouth cover.
How is he like person sized?
Yes.
Oh.
Wearing a hat.
He's wearing a hat.
Didn't get that.
Wearing a hat?
Do we think fedora or top hat? I'm going to go fedora.
I was going to go with fedora. Yeah.
Yeah.
Does he have a bullwhip too? Like, is he full Indiana Jones right now?
No, he's naked besides the fedora. No genitalia,
yeah, I
though.
I definitely saw amoeba boys.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
But think classic, like, fake puke where it has, like, the carefully placed, like, red and green, you know?
Big chunks. Yeah.
And horrible. It's, the
yellowy color.
Yeah, the pinkish yellowy color.
That vile, yellowy, green.
But it's also, like, silly putty, you know?
You hate to
I would
say
like
it.
To.
Did
I would
you
like
guys
to
know
use...
that color is real?
I would like to use my jump.
You're,
what?
You want to use your jump? Explain your jump.
I turn around, I get spooked, and I'm jumping over it, and I'm getting out of this bar.
You want to jump over?
You want to clear?
I'm using my special jump. I haven't used it yet.
Yep.
Oh, you've used the amoeba boy.
So when you turn around, he does not resist. I mean, he's like, so if he has your if he's holding your mouth from behind, when you turn around, it like
curls.
It curls around because it's not, you know, he doesn't actually have a limb, so it just keeps on sliding over. So he's still covering your mouth, and then you're gonna try to do the the launch over him. Roll your jump skill.
Do I get more jump for this one jump?
Yes. What did we say?
Plus five, I believe.
I don't remember.
Do you feel an extra little surge of jump for plus 20 jump?
Ooh. Hell yeah! I'm gonna change it to 40 just for now, and I'll change it back. Boom. Hell yeah.
Wow.
Damn.
So you try to, I'm assuming you're somehow using the urinal or wall to like launch yourself over.
I'm like, yeah, I like step up on the little like
yeah.
triangle lip of it and then bound over.
Yeah, when you do that,
it's the most dexterous an 85-year-old man has ever been.
You've been able to feel your extra jump that you have from several episodes ago now, and you do feel it like all suck through your body as you jump, and you like literally are leaving this magic jump power in the urinal as you launch over. So it was like your last bit of special jump. And as you fly through the air, you feel your normal jump returning, but you do clear the spot. So when you jump, he's not able to like wrap around like the vomit stream fast enough. So it just kind of, what you had on your mouth separates out, and there's like throwing spaghetti at a wall. Basically, you hear like the splat of vomit on the ground as you fly over and land.
Horrible.
What do you do?
I'm leaving the bathroom. I want to get out of this bathroom very badly. Okay.
As you're running out, you see that he's like, you kind of blew through his top half a little bit, so he's like reforming and trying to like reach around for his hat too.
Velma on the floor, just like.
Everybody in the bar sees PT Sinclair burst through the bathroom door and come running out into the main bar area.
Does he have vomit on him?
Oh yeah,
bile. Bile monster!
He's wet.
Oh, are you okay? No,
I'm very upset.
Oh,
he got
really drunk.
Viscerally upset.
Oh, no. That old man is covered in his own
shit. No, y'all.
Can we get some club soda or something?
You guys are thinking that I maybe had one too many and had released myself in the restroom. That's not what happened. I implore someone to look in there. Please.
Now that you say that, I'm on the same page as I am.
I don't know.
Because words are failing me for what's happening and what needs to happen as
I feel
now.
Like there might be someone whose unfortunate job that might be, but I don't feel like it's your traveling companion's duty to go clean up after you.
It is a giant slime monster that smells very pukey.
You know,
and it's horrible.
You know,
and I'm very scared.
Robin,
PT, we went through this. Yes,
it's in the men's bathroom, so maybe you want to.
I don't think
there's anyone else in there. I don't know why we have to be prudish about.
He looks like he's just thrown up. By the way,
his decorum to these things. His face is wet.
Like you know, when you've seen somebody who's just thrown up, it's like when somebody's just drinking milk and you can still like see it on the edges.
Just right here, and it's like, oh, come on!
It does not look good.
One of the many embroidered handkerchiefs that he definitely has, and wipes it off.
Oh, I'm gonna ask the bartender for like a mop or something. Like, sorry, my friend, you know, he got a little. Can I do something to clean up?
Have we talked to the bartender before?
I don't think so.
Probably.
Wait, is it Slim Jim?
Yeah, is it Slim Jim?
Slim Jim was the bartender at the Hoot Nanny.
Oh, this is not the Hoot Nanny, right? This is
not Slim Jim, by the way. Slim Jim.
Slim is my name. Howdy, folks. It's me again.
Oh, hey, Slim Jim. How are you?
Yes, we have a mop. We have tons of mops. Well,
Do you have a mop that also has the capability of killing monsters? Because that's the kind of mop you'll need. For the monster that's in the bathroom.
Nope, just normal mops.
Okay.
I'll take one that he offers.
You now have a mop.
And I will go. I'm going to grab PT by the scruff of the neck and say, have to come in and help me.
No,
you,
I don't want to.
If you made the monster, you
got
to clean him up. That's how
it
works.
It squishes when you hold the back of his collar because it was from like wrapping around.
Come on, dude. What?
Terrible.
How did you do? This is not even.
This is what I'm saying.
Okay,
it didn't come from my mouth.
Maybe I
really
do need to see this.
Oh, PT.
I gotta see what's up with this. I'm gonna join you, Robin. Let's
Spokes. Charlie Brown walks into the.
I pull out my.
How about, I'm gonna go ahead. I'm gonna ask the bartender if they have any sort of detergent or soap.
Any extra strength?
Yeah.
Yeah, we have soap. We just have a bunch of loose loose bars of soap, actually.
That's... Just anything that kind of sanitizes the air, because, you know.
Sure. Let me get you that. He hands you a burlap sack filled with just loose bars of soap.
All I can think about...
Are we going to make a blackjack with this now? Like,
all I can think about is this TikTok that me and Jorge watched that was just somebody... Like scrubbing their hands on a bunch of soap.
That's probably where it comes from.
Like dozens of bars of soap. Yeah.
No, but it was like an ASMR one, so it's a bunch of like loose clickety clacky. They're like soft, round.
in like a very shallow pool of water.
They look like rocks at first, and then turns out it's soap. But yes, do you have a burlap sack full of soap now?
Tremendous.
Probably had more views than anything I've ever made.
Probably anything any of us have ever done combined.
I was gonna say.
Cool.
Well,
all
right,
I'll take the burlap sack and I'm going to follow these guys because it beats drinking alone. So
Scoop is an aspiring ASMR artist. She's going to take all his bars of soap.
ASM artist.
Cut little slits in them and then shave them off.
Yes, there is a very satisfying click and clack to the soap bars as they shift around in your burlap sack.
Goes, oh, excuse me. Let me get my notepad out.
So you enter the bathroom, and most of the bathroom looks fine, but in the urinal there is like a large amount of puke, mainly in the urinal, with like a small trail leading away from, but it's more like a poo-poo splatter zone. You know, it's like a splatter zone right in front of the urinal. It's not like a trail leading anywhere. And if you look closer at the puke, particularly in the urinal, you can see that it has bits and remnants of P.T. Sinclair's famous elixirs, such as like coffee grounds and orange juice. You know, like, you know it to be ingredients from his elixirs.
Those are my staples.
PT, I have never seen your elixir do this to someone. I'm pretty sure I've seen it kill someone and it still didn't do this to them.
Well,
it pukes in a urinal.
Wait, so the slime's not here?
No.
What?
So they don't see it, but I also don't see it.
Yeah, no, it's not just in your mind. It is.
Cool.
Yes.
That's crucial. Yeah,
yes, very, very fair. You also see it. And it's definitely, you are confused about where it could have gone.
Can I make an investigate check or something?
An investigate check? So the one check that you can't make is you're an investigator. You have to investigate.
Yeah, I want
to
do a general.
You have to investigate. It's
I
not
was
just...
really hoping that we switched to D&D. For
you have
today.
To use yeah, your you own just... investigative, that's your own brain.
Just reading through the list of skills.
There's a trail? Like, is there a slimy trail leading anywhere?
No, like I said, there's a splatter zone in, like, right in front of the urinal, which you know clearly to be from when you kind of busted through them a little bit, leaping over.
Yeah. Can I make a spot hidden roll?
Yes.
Boom. Fuck.
That's okay.
Close. It was close, actually.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Was close. I needed under a 26.
Do not forget about luck. Or pushing it.
It's only 8 luck. I shouldn't push it. But the odds of me missing it twice in a row.
Do you want to push it?
You only have a 26.
You have a 26. You have a 1 in 4 chance both times.
I'm going to push it.
Describe
mostly
what you
because I want to see how Jorge manages to punish me if I fail. This
oh, so
me.
Easy.
Oh, that's not. Yeah,
so
that
first, so you finish. You so.
It was even worse.
You
so bad.
Finish invest like doing your first sweep of the bathroom and not noticing anything. And which way do you search harder for a clue? Just your normal first cursory glance came up with nothing.
Like. We're at the urinals, which is usually at the front of the bathroom. So I'm like, I'm going in and I'm like checking stalls, like deeper into the bathroom.
Okay, you're checking
doors
through.
Doors open.
Yeah, you're checking through the individual stall. Well, you would have checked the stalls if you were looking for it. You need to push it harder. What do you?
Really
what's a more intense?
Yeah. You got, because that's the thing, is usually these pushes go badly because people are doing something to put themselves in a little more peril in order to get to.
I'm checking vents. I'm like checking vents in the bathroom and like windows and seeing if there's any way that it could have escaped not through the door that I left and also came in.
Yeah, perfect. So you're checking through the different vents, and you start messing around with one, and the vent actually pops open a little bit, and a bunch of rats come running down and start scurrying all over you. Are you afraid of rats?
Easily the worst day I've ever had.
And roll.
I was caught in the middle of a stampede of buffalo one time while I was on the road.
Yes, the rats are like crawling down your clothes and everything. Roll.
Rat damage.
It's like flip a coin for whether you lose one damage, basically. You just do roll one D2. You can do it on
Uno.
Cool. So they do not bite you on their way through your clothing.
Thank goodness.
They just scare
you. Your little schmeckle's okay.
I am still, oh god! I think they're biting me! Oh look! Oh god! Someone please help! Call an exterminator!
Well, this commode is filthy.
The men's bathroom. This is pretty average for a bar setting.
This is a bad place.
I'm not surprised.
My investigations have taken me many places, but this is one of the worst.
I'm not surprised that they swarmed you when you're covered in vomit. Why did you do this?
Who likes vomit?
Happened? Did you drink your own elixir?
I didn't know rats were cool with vomit.
Who likes your elixir? Why did you put that in your mouth hole?
My elixirs are great. Who hasn't tried one?
Then why did you throw it up all over the place?
Here, I'll, you take the.
I
I'll
slap
rinse
it away.
He
tries to give it to me.
I'm gonna give him. I'm gonna jangle around in my burlap sack full of soap that I now have. I'm just gonna give him a couple bars.
Do you?
It feels like they just stole a bunch from the hotel and are like, "Here, we have soap for you.
This is to clean our bar."
Here's what I'm gonna say. It's going in the inventory.
Robin Renard does.
How many hours do you give me?
Those are going right into the elixir.
Instead of going in your inventory, you use it on your old man body.
Okay. Emily, in real life. Quickly can you use a full bar of soap?
Depends on how hard you're scrubbing, dude.
I don't know
how many elixirs I get to get a center of a Tootsie Pop.
Just like a bathroom, just do a little.
Were you okay with
that? I still have 15 sixteenths of a bar of soap.
You use a sixteenth of a bar of soap every time you shower? That's a lot. Are you okay with Robin Renard knocking your elixir out of your hand?
Yeah, I've got plenty.
Cool. Yeah. Then it shatters on the ground and there's a shattered elixir on the ground.
Literally no one buys it.
there's like a green puff of smoke that makes like a skull and crossbones.
Yeah. It hisses like a cobra. Like, wait a minute.
My dear Robert, that was one of my most expensive elixirs. Do you have any idea the number of ingredients that goes into that and the process of brewing it?
Yes.
Obviously,
I've watched you for 20 years. I've seen you do it over the course of 20 years.
Well, then you know that you have to pay me your spending level for today.
What's a spending level?
You can't just have him give you his whole spending level. That would have to come out of his cash, or else y'all would have unlimited money.
What's your spending level? It's like $10.
You owe me $10, Robert.
Don't owe you $10.
I will take this to my grave.
Okay, so okay. if you didn't throw up, then what are you telling us happened here?
Like, I was okay. I don't want to get too blue, but I was urinating in the urinal.
Okay.
And behind me
on your dick. We get it. You gave yourself a chili dog.
I did not. I don't even know what that is, but it sounds horrible in context.
He just cackles.
Chili dog. I was relieving myself, and from behind me, a giant monster that looked like a very large pile of vomit wearing a fedora put a weird tendril of seemingly vomit around my mouth. It had a fedora
wearing
on.
A fedora?
I don't. It was wearing a fedora.
E.T., you gotta look. I get that you need to add a little bit of the fantastique when you say these stories, but like, come on. Like, the level. How am I gonna believe that? Like,
how can I prove that? I don't.
I don't know. You can't. You just have vomit all over your dick. You got
to show you my
chili dog,
vomit free.
Okay, so if there was a vomit monster or whatever you're saying happened, I mean, I guess I saw an acid horse.
We are operating under the assumption that weird shit has not been happening in this town.
Okay.
So
where do you propose that monster ran off to?
I don't know. I was looking for it, and then I was swarmed by rats. So I'm done looking. I'm just sad and covered in vomit.
Maybe if someone tried to pee in the urinal again.
It really... Wait.
He said he was peeing in the urinal.
So it's attracted to someone peeing?
Not me because I'm done.
Okay, so there's...
My tank is empty.
That's good.
If it's made of vomit, then it definitely left a trail, right? So let's go see if we can find a trail. Can you handle that?
I am amenable to that, yes.
Awesome. Okay. Let's find this vomit trail.
I'll formally try to look for a vomit trail leaving the room.
I'd pull out
a magnifying glass.
Hidden around here I want to look. I want to do the
You know, I've never
close against the wall where you're like
I've never figured out what to do in these situations where everybody can just roll, you know? But We'll allow it for now. Everybody can roll a spot.
I failed.
Brutal.
Oh!
Whoa!
Robin Renard rolled
a
critical success.
Which is a one.
Sherlock fucking
that's
Holmes
the, that's
over
the
here.
Second critical success of the game.
Oh!
So, you're looking for the vomit trail, right? Mario. You're looking all over the bathroom. You're not seeing it like right outside the splatter trail, and it's not until you look at the on one of the walls of the bathroom is like the little thin window at the top, you know?
Yes.
And you notice that it's open and that there is like a little bit of vomit like on one part of it, like a print.
I can say, guys, I think come take Oh, guys, you gotta come see this. And then I force them all over with the cliche.
Oh,
and then I point
do you believe me now? You guys have been pretty cool about it, like, in the last couple of seconds. But, like, I hope you super believe me now. I wasn't vomiting up in the windowsill.
Let's take I'm a little skeptical now that you said you didn't do it, but I'll follow this lead. I'll follow this.
Let's see wherever
it takes me.
See where this trail leans.
The spot hidden does your so it's your masterful investigative skills that led you to check not only that the window was open and there was a spot at it. And it's particularly because of this critical success that you got with knowing like you're in the zone right now.
I know what I'm looking for too.
You do intuit that for some reason there is vomit on the windowsill and some in the stall, but not any in the trail, like none trailing over there. So right now you're curious about how, if it is a vomit monster, it would manage to.
How did it get up there without leaving a trail towards that? Like there's nothing that suggests it's going up something or around something else.
Right.
It's been out in the cold air long enough and it's got sort of like a crust around the outside of it. God. And so it's sort of formed a protective film.
Surprisingly insightful yet horrid thought, Scoop. Thank you.
I'm here to investigate. You know? Here to come up with solutions.
It jumped Maybe it saw, maybe it was very successful at jumping.
PT's like 2/3 of the way through this barb, so at this point.
Do we want to check the outside of the bar and see if we can find a trail out of the window?
Trying to think of what's the upside to it. Like, we find it, and then what?
I mean, it attacked PT Sinclair, and
yeah,
presumably...
He got out okay. Like,
I've been attacked before. I wouldn't necessarily call it, and it surprised me, definitely, but it didn't, like, hit me or, like, do any physical damage to me.
So
I'm just
ran away.
Yeah.
So you didn't ask it any questions or?
It's a giant pile of bile.
It was wearing a fedora. Clearly, it understands on some level that's clothes. And it
so everything wearing a fedora sense. Is highly intelligent. I disagree.
I think the fact that it wasn't attacking you suggests that it was on some level intelligent. Although, really, if it knew you, then why wouldn't it attack you? That's actually the surprising thing.
Hurtful and unnecessary, Robert.
I'll let you roll your Cthulhu Mythos skill because you do have a vague memory of having encountered something similar to this before. Did both of you fail?
Yeah.
Both did really bad.
I have zero
yeah,
Cthulhu
you can't
Mythos.
Yeah, no,
I guess if you roll a one.
They're the only ones with Cthulhu Mythos though. Because they've been adventuring a long time.
That's 20, 23.
I know.
Luck.
I thought I had some too.
You
I'm
are from
spend...
the old days, aren't you?
I am. I don't know why I don't have any.
You might have some occult.
You know what? I don't think.
You know what? I do have a cult.
That's
what it
was. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That's
no,
what
I think we never gave it to her because she never played. Didn't... She didn't play this round, so she didn't set up that stuff.
Exactly. Exactly.
How, do y'all both have this? Do you both have the same occult
points to succeed on this roll?
You need. You're using your luck.
Yeah, I'm using 23 luck to do it.
Okay.
Oh shit.
Fair enough. So
41 is what I'm at now.
You do remember having fought other creatures that are like sloppy, more formless style, right? And there are in other occasions there have been ones in which pieces of them can separate, but they are still part of the whole.
I do
so
remember this.
It can his acting skills. So it's like, and in the past, even when pieces separate, they can still bring them back and sometimes are even hurt if one of their little pieces are hurt. So where your mind is leading you now based off of that is potentially if there's
flush
anything
that vomit down the
there's anything you can do with the vomit that's already that you have there and available to you.
We could drop some soap in it.
I'm gonna go up to the vomit.
I have some
it's
soap.
It's not moving or anything. Like it's just oh god.
Some soap ASMR.
Oh, terrible.
That does honestly that sounds pretty close to it though.
That's what it sounded like.
Yeah.
I really want you guys to share this video with me.
I find it.
Dude, at this rate, this is just gonna become an ASMR Twitch stream, so enjoy.
I remember who was with us in that game where we were fighting the I don't remember what the deal with them was. I remember fighting them.
To be clear, this is a memory from one of your adventures that we've never played.
Right.
It's PT Sinclair's memory, but it's not a real event that happened to
But us. Robert Renard would have been there.
Yes.
Yes.
Cool.
Dude,
cool.
Just above table, sure. this is an
Remy
opportunity to just make up lore.
I don't
you
think.
Could just yeah.
No.
Have been there. Definitely
and
not.
Scoop definitely wouldn't have, but Robin would.
Scoop
yes.
might have.
So
Scoop's from the old days.
She
was
likely
around in the old days for like 2 seconds.
Exactly. So like she may have jumped across, but
oh yeah, I guess
so,
we didn't really
because she started as a child. That's why she's only 24,
yeah,
right? She was a kid when she started.
Because it's been 20 years.
Yeah, I did.
So, Robin, I remember.
Why am I 24?
It looked like creatures that we have fought before, but I'm I relay to him what you told me.
I'm trying to remember what the deal with them was. And I don't, I am failing. PT is failing and yes. John is also failing.
Oh, okay.
Is what I'm getting at.
I feel like we fought something like that. I want to say in St. Louis, something like that. It was one of those Midwestern sure. things. It was not, I don't remember. I don't remember liking fighting anything like that. And I remember it being gross, but
I remember them being very yucky.
Yes.
And them, I remember their hits being very like visceral and hard.
So what are we doing here then? Are we going to follow? Are we going to leave? Are we going to go drink some more?
It is definitely a monster. Even though it didn't attack me, it's definitely a monster based on what I know of monsters I've fought before. So we probably shouldn't just like let it stroll around. Also, it's made of vomit, and that sucks.
I point to the big puddle of it in here, and I go, I don't think they can talk, because, you know, the whole no mouth and no whatever. But maybe you could, like, psychically try and say hello or something. Get in touch with its little, you know, thing going on. Because there's a bunch right here, and I assume this is at least part of it, because...
Yeah.
You didn't vomit this out, did you? Or did I?
I just pointed out. Didn't vomit anything.
Smash cut to when he originally vomited it out.
I would like to dip a pinky into the pile.
Into the pool of clairvoyance.
And clairvoyance.
So, roll your clairvoyance.
You know what? All I can think of is
fuck me sideways.
Wow,
this is karma from
this
last
is from
episode.
The other time when you were
last episode.
It,
yeah. I was rolling like crazy numbers, and today
it always comes back around.
Ugh. Yeah, I needed under a 58. I rolled a 98. That sucks.
To see it.
When you lift your pinky out, there's like the strand, you know.
Come on. Why you gotta do that?
I'm working with what I got here, man.
It's just gross.
I think the narrative justification is that PT is so viscerally grossed out by the whole thing.
You don't feel good.
His mind shuts down.
You can't even jump so good no more.
I would love to, Robert, okay, I'd love to be able to see anything about this, but I can't.
If we something better.
That sounds good. I'm
okay.
I'm with that.
I'm going to apologize to the pile of vomit. I'm gonna say sorry. We don't know how to. We'll see you later, probably.
By mixing it into the water system, is that
definitely
cool?
Gonna make a huge issue? 100%.
Is it gonna make it cool or real bad?
Two options here. It's either gonna dissipate it entirely because it's all gonna fall into little chunks and it's gonna be whatever.
Yeah.
Or it's somehow going to create a bigger weave of vomitness with the other stuff that's inside of the sewer, and it's just going to be more of a problem.
This is,
but it never attacked you, so really, I don't know what.
Is Scoop just doing it, or are you waiting for them to?
I think I'm just gonna do it at this point because I feel like either way, it sort of moves whenever this is along, and I will no longer be in a men's room. Discussing this with near total strangers. So
it is horrible in here. There's not even any place to sit.
I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna take some shavings of one of these bars of soap and I'm gonna sprinkle it on top of the vomit in the urinal, and I'm just gonna flush it away.
You hit the flusher.
Slide whistle sound for that flush.
Well, you hit the flusher and it starts doing like the. But immediately all of the vomit like starts tendriling out and starts scurrying out of the urinal.
It's real. No. Oh, it's real. I really thought he was senile. All right.
Okay.
And well, he is, but he's sometimes right.
Porque no los dos.
He says that.
I'm pulling out my baseball bat.
He speaks Spanish, so.
I'm taking out my baseball bat.
As it starts, it's scurrying across the bathroom floor. P.T. Sinclair feels all of the vomit on him start to crawl. Starts like thick dripping quicker now coming down your clothing and
oh my god. Oh my
And it's all like all these little the little droplets joining with the small mass that has exited the urinal.
I
would like to fire my elephant gun at the mass.
Okay, roll your elephant gun roll.
There's the roll.
12 damage.
12 damage.
So you fire it directly at the mass where all the little other bits were like coming to join in it, and it does. You hit it straight on, and there is like the small like fountain up of which does splatter everybody a little bit. And you hear from out like right outside the window like a gurgly no.
Hold on. Are you?
Wait. Yeah. I don't want to fight this if we don't have to.
Are you?
Do we go out? Do
Sorry.
We go outside?
Are you the, outside?
You see we're the other outside. The any like the remaining bits that were not in the central mass all like continuing to crawl up the wall and like go for the window.
I'm sprinting.
Say
out
we
the
go
door.
Outside.
Yeah.
I'm
running out there.
Y'all get to.
I'm gonna pass the bar and I'm gonna. Slam some money down and ask for a bottle of vodka as we leave the bar.
Sure thing. Everything look okay in there?
Not really. No.
I'd put up a sign.
There's a whole lot of vomit in there.
I'd put up a sign. It was worse than we thought.
Yeah. Oh, phew. I thought you were going to talk about the rats. That's good. Just if it's just the vomit, that happens like every night.
You know what? There was so much vomit, I actually forgot about the rats.
Well, at least it wasn't the squirrel, right?
No.
Okay. I give a concerning look
a
as I'm leaving.
A
but
sign
I don't
would
say
be nice, but also that bottle of vodka would be fantastic. How much do I owe you?
$1 million.
$200? What did we say it isn't?
$200?
Oh. What is this, a nightclub in 2020?
Sorry, no, I did it the wrong way. $2.
Like I was going to say, like.
Went the wrong direction with that.
Okay. I would also like a
$200 bottle of vodka in that day and age. Holy shit.
I would like a glass of absinthe for to go.
Is anybody else staying to order drinks or the rest of you?
You're
ready.
Literally grabbing a bottle of vodka and leaving, like running.
You stayed and had a conversation with him. So everybody else who's running is like out the door.
Question.
That's how conversations start.
Sorry, I'm not rude.
Means you have to do.
Yes, he did. I mean, I often try to hold people back by getting them stuck in long conversations.
Inane conversation.
Taking it and leaving.
Does he pour the absinthe?
Yeah. So to be clear, Robin and Remy are running out the door.
Just sprinted out the door.
Scoop is just finished getting the bottle from Jim and is now trying to catch up with them, and you are sitting at the bar waiting as he pours you a glass of absinthe.
Yes. Do I get the absinthe?
Yes.
I pour it in my water skin. I dropped $2 and now I'm leaving.
Cool.
Wait, is a glass of absinthe the same price as a bottle of vodka? Or was he tipping?
I'm tipping. He put down $2. I don't know. I didn't tell him to put down $2. He put down $2. You asked for
a
bottle
water
of vodka
skin that has coffee, lemonade, gimlet, and absinthe in it. This is going to make for a good elixir, y'all.
Oh, God, I hope you kill a player
heaven
with that.
Why do you want to kill so
don't forget
much
that he gave me an elixir.
Robin, Renard, and Remy McSquemmy arrive to where the window is behind the bathroom.
Okay.
Outside
the
bathroom.
Can I see the vomit monster
what
thing
is out here?
You look out and you can see, I mean, it's like, it's the alleyway, but it's like you were coming around from the street to get to that alley, and you can,
okay,
you don't see anything right outside the bathroom window, but as you're scanning the area, you look off and it's like heading down the street under one of the street lamps, just off in the distance. You see it. He stops and he does the Bigfoot pose, you know, the
this one.
Yeah. And it's,
is it like a humanoid creature? Like
it's like limbs, but they're all very like loosey-goosey, right? He just kind of like forms them around as
he has legs too, or
yeah it's like two
bottom.
It's two like think even more humanoid than amoeba boys
context
but yeah, so he stops mid Bigfoot. You can see him wearing the fedora. And he sees.
Wait a minute!
I told you. What did I say?
I'm like running out of the bar, pouring the absinthe into my water skin. Like I told. Look at the fedora. You made fun of me.
Fine. Everybody sees him then, and then he runs. He runs off into the night.
I'm gonna go wait, and I'm gonna chase after him.
I give chase.
I also
into the night.
It.
Y'all are gonna give full chase.
Yeah.
Okay.
Absolutely.
Let's.
What else am I going to do?
So they
do we have a plan?
Find a home? Fuck you. Absolutely not.
No, I'm going to stay up forever.
Find a permanent residence? No.
Day four forevermore.
I thought we were in the motel.
Nope. No. Motel's gone.
It's burned.
Sorry.
Oh.
Yeah. Yes.
What stuff was in there?
We should tell you something.
Your stuff is
so Scoop would be
fine.
Yeah, yeah, Scoop's
Scoop
fine.
Ah, yes.
Fine.
You're allowed to go back to the motel.
And I got my stuff.
I thought you guys blew it up or something.
No. We blew someone up, but
at
not.
The end of
or
this
as we're concerned, what we've done is effectively fine. That, but no,
right,
not
so we're
literally.
Chasing.
Yes. There is a chase mechanism in Call of Cthulhu, but it is long and hard and requires lots of pen and paper and everybody staring and lots of rolls. So we won't be doing that. What are y'all's dexterities? Who has the highest dexterity?
Oh,
55.
I'm 60.
There it is. Okay.
So
do I roll?
No. Y'all are running after it. But you're pretty differently speeded than each other. So Scoop is the only one that manages to like pull ahead of the pack and is the only one that manages to catch up with the monster right as he's about to enter the woods on the edge of town.
Oh, wait, hold up. We just want to talk to you.
Scoop, take a picture of it.
I have my camera, but I get consent first. What? Hello?
You're gaining on it. He is not replying to you. He's about to like run right into the forest.
Wait! I like pull out my camera and I like go to take a picture of it and it flashes. Does that do anything for him?
let's find out right
now. I could do something violent, but I don't want to.
Fair enough.
Good. What a departure from every other decision we've made in this game.
Well, the thing is, like, I have one move, but he's not going to like it.
you flash the camera, and... Yep, he's, like, it. You see his, the like, tendrils shoot out of him for a second and come back in, and he slows to a stop and, like, ducks behind a tree. And you did also get a picture of him.
Sweet. That's all I cared about. That's why I'm here.
Are you going to sell that to the paper? Horrible vomit monster runs around the city.
This thing exists.
Muck runs amok. Like.
Very good.
I should be the editor.
Yeah. Well, you're not. I
damn.
Am. And the photographer and the journalist. All right.
The Daily Bugle? What did we decide on?
Beagle.
The Daily Beagle.
Beagle, I think is
Daily
what it is.
Daily Beagle. It is. It's like, all right. So I can see you had... Sorry, I needed a snack. Emily needed a snack, so now Scoop is eating. I can see you behind the tree there, and I just want to know, are you particularly shy, or are you incapable of speech? Or is it both?
Great question.
¿Por qué no los dos?
Is that what he said?
Alright, I'm gonna start.
No,
we heard it speak, kind of, before.
That's
no.
True.
The bathroom still.
I'm gonna start inching my way around towards it, but very slowly, like I'm approaching a scared animal.
You can, it's like trying to stay kind of low and crouched, and every time you like walk around enough to see it a little bit, it keeps on creeping around the tree slowly.
We just want to talk to you because we thought that old guy was lying about your existence and whatnot.
Everybody, the rest of the party catches up with you standing at the edge of the forest staring at a tree.
Oh, jeez. This is a horrible day.
I really got to work on my cardio.
Stop hyperventilating. Look at this.
Whoa. Is it? Are you?
It stopped.
can you talk?
It just cowers more and is like hiding behind the tree.
Okay.
PT, it wanted to talk to you. Go say something.
Yeah.
PT's the one with the connection.
You made
it. I really
it.
Don't. Okay.
It All really right. seems like you made it now.
It's okay. Your son.
I mean, I go up, I walk up slowly to it, hand outstretched, and I say, I'm sorry that I got scared and did a super sweet backflip over you.
That dog, who has the bag of bones, by the way?
I think I still do. I don't think I ever relinquished them.
No, I have the suit jacket.
I have a bag of soap now.
There's
it
that
might be Conrad.
There's that dog Seymour, who's there and is now barking at the vomit monster.
Yeah.
And
I don't know how I keep forgetting you're here, dog.
Oh God, you're still here, dog.
And the three ghosts that you have collected in the bag of bones all pop out and are like, Jesus. What the hell is that thing?
Do you guys like?
I forgot about you guys.
Do you guys like sleep and then just pop out when you wake up? Like, what's the deal with?
Oh, I remember these guys. Are you all together now?
Hey, yeah, Tomahawk here. We don't sleep, but it takes a lot of work to keep our corporeal forms.
And this was the so okay. So it seems like maybe this was a crucial moment.
And,
for you,
Gob,
do you have anything to say about the vomit monster?
Gob is like, yeah, that's a lot. Oh, wait. Nope. He's not gobberting when I was just Gob. Yeah, that's a lot of puke.
Always got to point out the obvious. There.
Reminds me of New Year's.
Horrible.
Gob.
What are you guys doing here? What do you want? Why now? Go away.
What do you know about this creature? Do you know anything about this creature?
Nope. We just
Tomahawk. I want to hear from you.
Hi, Tomahawk here. Nope. We just thought it would be a good time to pop out. You know, spice things up a little bit.
Love it.
We make things more vanilla. I'm tired of the spice. Honestly, I can't.
I look up at the sky. What time is it?
It is night. It is not like midnight
curfew
yet.
Time,
we said midnight was curfew.
Yeah,
time, right?
Midnight is what we said.
I think
yes.
Midnight's curfew. Shit. We need to. How close is it to midnight though? We need
still,
to like find
gotta,
a place.
Yeah, you still got a few hours. Like
fuck.
It's not.
Okay.
Don't you know?
What
don't,
happens at midnight?
We something bad. That's all we know. Is there something bad?
There's some scary
there's a curfew?
Fellows, and I may or may not have hurt their horses. And they don't like
yes.
us very much. Yeah. And they come out at midnight. So
they come
no,
out.
No, that's
midnight.
Not even. No, there's something else at midnight, right?
Right.
Oh,
we don't.
The night guard just
I don't
runs
think
around.
We've seen what happens
yeah.
at midnight. We've seen the guard.
That's right.
They've come at us during the day. They don't care. They're just whatever. There's also something scary at midnight that does something horrible.
God, whatever happened to that guy who told us to come to this town in the first place?
Is that Baggy?
I
thought he. Oh.
He's still around town too.
That's
it?
Right, because PT.
He said he would find me. I'm very scared for many reasons.
Let's try.
This town is pretty freaky.
Let's try and get.
And I have like beef with no one.
I can't. I really can't tell. This thing looks very nervous.
Scoop. I assume. Oh, okay. You're talking about the puke monster. Okay. Sorry, it was going to try to sneak off since y'all were...
I'm going to point and go, this thing looks very nervous.
We decided to stop and talk about our fears.
I don't know. Maybe it'll be fine out on its own in the woods. I don't know the woods situation with this. I know the town is a problem.
Yeah, like, where is it trying to go?
My friend, I'm sorry that... I'm sorry if I scared you. You scared me, so, like... I think we're even, but I would like to extend an olive branch, and I just want to see what your whole deal is, my man.
Are you reaching your hand out?
I would like to attempt to charm it, if that's possible.
Yes, roll charm.
Wow.
Ooh. He needed a 96, ooh, and he got exactly a 96.
Razor's edge.
That's,
and luckily no higher.
That is Lord insane, dude. That is crazy. I cannot roll like that. That is the worst I can roll
without it being
and still succeed.
He's making some whimpering sounds, but one of his like his clearly his arm tendril starts reaching out towards your hand.
I like wince as I like reach my hand. Like I'm not moving my hand closer than it already is, and I'm like.
And right as your hands are about to touch, y'all, everybody hears the crack of a gunshot, and it goes, there's another splatter of vomit, and the creature runs off into the woods.
Oh, my friend.
No! We didn't even get to name pistol. It!
I'm going to pull out my pistol and whip around.
Yeah, you.
I just have my bottle of vodka.
I
still have
my I cracked the bottle of vodka.
I think PT,
I will, if
I think
need
PT
be.
Goes prone. With this,
PT goes horizontal.
You
lays down back up.
PT goes supine. Yeah,
he starts to plank. Remember planking?
Yo,
yeah.
You
PT was the first one to do it, actually.
So you turn around to see where the gunshot came from.
Yeah, did we not say that? We should. Yes.
Well,
we
Robin. Robin was like. Robin only said that. Yeah.
You went prone, and then you went on your back, and then you went back. You just started rolling over like a log, and then Scoop and Remy were terrified of this.
Yes, yeah.
I need to teach myself to sleep on my side.
You turn around, and you see mounted on a bicycle is the one that you have come to know as Baggy, and he's like, "Woo, Baggy! Yes, yes." Try making friends with that thing now, you fuckers. I'm.
Hey!
Woo!
I don't even know you. That's awful rude.
We
dick?
Were just and talking then about you.
He turns away and just starts hauling ass on his bicycle away from y'all, dinging his little bell as he goes.
Hey! Baggard!
Fuck!
Hey!
Who
Baggard,
does that?
Come back!
Man, I don't have anything that I can throw without killing him.
I'm
gonna say I could shoot him.
What a
bottle
dick.
Of vodka at him. That kind of seems a waste of vodka.
Absolutely a waste of vodka.
He was already.
Baggy, do you want to buy any elixirs?
He was already distance away from y'all, and he had like a rifle. A big rifle he just has like slinged around his back now as he's bicycling away. And he's going very quickly, so he's already like. You can still see him riding down the street, but it is a ways away.
Where did
he get a bike from?
I don't know why I 100% imagined him on a tricycle.
Like a big wheel. Like, yeah. Like
I fucked it up. I fucked it. We got to get him a tricycle. Anyways,
he'll upgrade the next time.
We get the sense that he was aiming for the puke monster.
Yes.
He said, try making friends with that now and then
There's a jest and a playfulness to his demeanor that shows that he's out to get you in the worst way, which is ruining all of your fun. Anyways, that's where we will leave it while we take a quick break. And
Don't worry.
Wait,
Do not be concerned.
Don't worry.
Just chill the fuck out.
Don't worry. We'll be right back.
We'll be right back.
Bye.
And we're back.
Did you worry? You shouldn't
have. I hope you didn't.
It literally says on the message.
We said specifically, do not.
They could be worried, just not about us, you know?
Yeah, if you're worried about other
stuff, you're
allowed
to worry
about
other things.
Of course.
But if you're worried about whether or not we'll be back,
don't pile us into that.
Scythe says they were worried.
Damn.
Ah, shit.
Anyways.
Okay, don't be worried. Now that I got... an affirmative yes, we were. Now I feel to blame.
Gonna be doting over
and
the
I feel
whole
bad.
Night.
I was judging before and now I feel bad.
We gotta say don't worry even more times before we hit breaks down.
Please now, don't
we
worry.
We should
please.
Hit it a couple
please,
more times.
Please
don't
worry. Pretty please don't worry.
Please.
I'm just a werewolf.
There's an angry bird emoji. He's wearing a headset. Is there a name for that?
Hell yeah, dude.
It was the perfect emoji for the
is
time.
Is that cat
I don't know
jail?
How to describe it. Is that cat jail?
When you said it's an angry bird emoji, I was like, oh,
the meme
like,
that I missed sorry. From before?
It's not angry bird like angry bird.
No, it is a bird.
It's just a bird.
No, it's a bird.
I definitely thought
is...
angry birds, and I was like, really?
Oh, I feel like it's a pidge, maybe.
It is.
It's a pidge.
It just reminds me. Once again, a hatiful boyfriend.
Hatiful boyfriend. Should stream that sometime.
Oh, yes.
Can we please?
Anyways.
Please, please.
P.T. Sinclair, you notice that your collar, the part that had been particularly soaked with vomit before, is like completely dry now.
I'm still going at it with the... I'm at like an eighth of a bar at this point. Like, I'm still going for it.
Oh, you are soaking it up. So, sorry, it's not completely dry. It is soapy.
I'm sudsing it up over here. Yeah.
Now, where are you getting the liquid?
Yeah.
To
are you just like spitting
concoction?
Yourself?
It may or may not be elixirs, which very much grosses real life John out.
It's
and
the elixirs,
for some
dude.
PT school with it.
What I'm saying is the vomit has all left along with the creature into the woods. But your soap, your neck collar is also sudsy, I guess, with elixir.
I relieved, honestly.
And Baggy is now completely out of view. The last thing that you experienced of him was like his bells dinging quietly in the distance.
Bing, bing, bing.
Okay, well, that guy I would like to figure out for sure. The vomit monster is gone. He's in the woods, and I am not fucking with that.
I would love a strong drink and a place to sleep. That sounds pretty good.
Couldn't agree more.
Strong drink
sounds nice.
Is great, but you definitely have a flask, and I have moonshine if you need it.
This bottle of vodka that I didn't end up molotoving into a vomit monster.
Was that your plan?
Scoop.
Yes. That was
a good plan.
100% my plan. Thank you.
Plan.
But then I realized that was a pretty cold thing to do to something.
Kind of dark to just arbitrarily. Yeah.
That was just running away from us. So.
Man,
I hit the brakes on that.
If Taylor was here, that thing would have been roasted up.
Everything
that thing would have
been roasted.
Super dead.
Baggy would have been shot.
Yeah,
would...
Look, if we get into trouble later, we still have it. Okay.
Of course. Love that. Love that you're prepared.
Love that.
Always be prepared.
So just a place to sleep is what you're getting at.
I have a place to sleep because I'm staying at the motel.
Last night was a close call for us because we were on someone's doorstep at like 11:59. And things were almost quite bad for us, so I don't want to get that close.
Scoop,
do you know that for certain, though?
Does Scoop read the newspaper?
Scoop is the newspaper.
Sounds like a no.
You are...
Scoop reads the newspaper, but Emily does not know what it says.
No, that's why I'm going to tell you now, since I realize you probably know some stuff.
Scoop
does not write for this newspaper because Scoop is new to town.
Newspaper. Scoop writes for her own paper.
Cool.
It's the Daily Beagle, right?
The Daily Beagle is the one in town. Yeah,
is the one in town.
But
yeah,
Scoop does remember reading a headline in the latest Daily Beagle, which specifically talks about the murder of Arnold Kokomo. And it is that you know that in the report they were saying that the newcomers are wanted for questioning. Right. And
so,
that in
the
descriptions, you were not one of them.
He's the housing guy, right? The housing magnate.
He's a local real estate
magnate.
He's
a magnate. He pulls real estate to him.
He's a magnate. Whatever.
Is he bringing new houses like a magnate?
This edition of Emily Says Words she's only read before, okay? At least I read.
Sorry, you're right. Yeah, that's a good
looks
point.
Looks at
good
John.
So you You do know something about the motel situation. You know you're good to go back there. You know the motel is the crime scene, and that.
And I know I'm hanging out with wanted people.
Yes, and that it from the newspaper article that they did not at all talk about police. They talked about the night guard who are out looking for them.
The night people.
Yes.
The night dude.
The nightman.
The nightman. Fighter of the nightman.
Which makes me think, should we just kill one of these guards? Should we?
Is that worse?
It'll definitely exasperate the issue.
Yeah.
We killed their horses and look what happened.
They're still pretty mad.
Exacerbate? Anyway.
Yes.
Yeah, see,
like
this
you
is
like
the
you
thing.
Exacerbate the situation.
You don't know because you don't read it. I'm sorry, Mike. Hold on one second.
So, if y'all are looking for places to go, some people that you've interacted with, she'll be back. Some people that you've interacted with, who I think you'd be able to find, are the teens.
Yes.
Zerone, Scratchy Hopefully. Tom, Slim Jim. The bartender,
Bandana Jones.
There's still the group that P.T. Sinclair talked to that nobody else knows about.
And nobody's supposed to know.
Very
about.
Clear that I'm not supposed to tell anyone about that shit.
Who else?
Dr. Zamenhof.
Dr. Zamenhof. Yeah. And Egg.
Egg.
Sunny Egg.
Sunny Egg. Yeah, we know where he lives now.
We do know where he lives.
Yes. So, just so you have as a reminder of the full roster.
I was going to look up Zerone Beppoli.
That was what I was going to say, was to look up Zerone.
Okay. To find a
Wait,
phone.
Did I get his number?
I was going to say, I was either going to look up in the white pages.
I thought we received some way to like close contact him.
I feel like my answer to everything is usually I'll find you, so I have no idea. Did you add it to your inventory, maybe?
No.
If that's like, I'm going to go to a phone that hopefully has the yellow pages attached to it, and I'm going to, or the white pages, whatever they are. And I'm going to look through, I'm going to flip through to Beppoli, because that's his last name.
I'm going to go to the BEs.
I'm going to go to the BE section.
You do see a phone, let's say full phone booth on the street near y'all.
Nice.
Is everybody else going with him?
Yeah, I do not know.
Everybody climb in.
Yeah, everybody's in there.
I don't know anything about the history of the phone and when things were.
I find out.
What I've learned from doing this campaign that takes place in the 30s is that there was a lot of stuff in the 30s that I did not know was in the
30s. Phone booth is a 2002 American neo-noir thrill. Oh, this isn't what I want.
So Robin Renard is looking through the phone booth. Is anybody doing anything different? Just standing around waiting for him to make a phone call.
I'm gonna smoke a cigarette and take a swig from my flask.
Hell yeah.
like a cool guy.
Yeah,
I'm taking my flask and I'm portioning it into elixir bottles.
I'm gonna pull out a pack of candy cigarettes and eat them one by one next to Remy, because I think she's cool, but I am not.
You do find Baron Zeppeli in the phone book.
I am going to call him.
I'm knocking on the side of the phone booth.
Did you find him? Yeah. I slam the phone book up to the window. I have the phone in the crook of my neck and I'm trying to.
I'm going to look over at Scoop and say, well, this looks promising, I guess.
Yeah, I get, more promising than anything else that's happened tonight.
I pull out an alchemy book and I start reading.
What are you doing?
Is your intent to go and sleep over at Baron's?
I'm going to call and see if he,
if we can sleep over.
Can we
come
over?
Absolutely. Hey, my mom said it was okay. Is it okay if your mom, can your mom say it's okay if I sleep over?
Well, Baron Zeppeli answers the phone.
You mean Zaren Beppeli?
I mean
Not Baron Beppeli. Not legally distinct.
I don't know who either of those people are.
It's okay. He's like, yes, hello.
Hi, Zerone. It's
Robin Renard. I've been expecting your call, sir.
Then I'm sorry for the delay. My companions and I were, we
need a place to stay, I'm sure.
You're really good at this. Yes. Could we trouble you for some shelter from the unspeakable horrors of the night?
Oh, you don't have anything for curfew. You need a full night getaway.
Yeah. We're not allowed at the motel because of the whole
the murder, because you murdered that man.
Well, it was really more self-defense, but we can get into that later. And we don't own a property yet. Oh, yes. D.T. Sinclair.
Oh, is he on the phone as well?
He's here, yeah.
Was this dude at my meeting?
No.
Okay. Ooh. That's all I need to know.
That's a good question, though.
Yeah, I probably shouldn't have just answered no.
He just straight up gave it. Yes.
They were wearing hoods. And to be clear, they were all hooded, and so you couldn't see.
You don't know
who was there, but now you know. It is no.
You in your mind's eye, you saw one that you thought looked like him, and then it was immediately revealed that he wasn't him.
It's
no.
He like went back. He had to scratch something on his head.
You have to. It's hard enough to come up with all these things. It's even harder to put the walls up in time as people ask me questions. A lot of threads going on here.
Oh my god!
Yes,
the benefit of doing an all improv.
Come right on over. I live at 18. Cobra Street.
Cobra Kive.
Yeah, just 18. Cobra, it's just 18 Cobra Kai. Cove.
18 Cobra Kai. Thank you, Zerone. We appreciate
it. I imagine it must be strange to you, but some of our... We have streets, lanes, and kais, and avenues.
Straight, I couldn't care less.
You know, street, road, boulevard, kai, court,
avenue.
We live in a quaint little town, don't we?
It's certainly little. I hang up the phone and I say, okay, Zerone Beppoli will let us stay at his house for the evening.
Thank goodness.
We still have time. And I kind of look at my watch. It's like,
ooh, do we want to have Scoop pick up our shit?
I have my stuff.
Conrad Hearty specifically did not
ignored
go to our rooms.
Yeah. Mine and PT Sinclair's stuff was
like
completely ignored. PT had to proclaim my bushel of apples.
My bushel of apples is still in my hotel room. They're probably bad by now.
Has it only been a day?
It's been like 2 days.
It's been like 2 days.
apples last longer than 2 days.
Like, it's been like
they're completely rotten.
Sorry. I don't know if Scoop has that knowledge.
This was before GMOs.
Roll Cthulhu Mythos.
Do you have an apple skill?
Survival.
Apple survival skills.
Is my car at the bar where we are?
Yes.
Yeah,
nice
right.
Rhyming.
You're
that's
not
good.
You're not at the bar though. You did chase the puke monster a few blocks over.
Okay.
Will my credit rating help me with the apple question?
That'll help when we need to buy a house.
Yeah, we'll assume that you know.
All right, you guys wanna drive on to walk? We'll walk on over to my car and then drive to what's his name?
Zerone Beppoli.
Zerone.
I'm still looking.
You have a car?
Amazing. I sure do.
I'm still looking out to see if I recognize that place from my vision that one time.
Oh.
Of the public speech.
The stump. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yes.
What about that dolphin vision you had? Wasn't that a thing?
That's most of them.
Now, Scoop, from what I understand, you're a journalist. Is that right?
I am.
Do you know anything about the ones
here in
town? She's also
a magnificent writer. She's going to help me write my autobiographical musical.
Oh, wow. That's exciting.
It's,
oh,
it, no. It's not something I've agreed to.
Is this all happening on the way?
This is the walking. Yeah. This is the Sorkin walk and talk. Of
I have not become acquainted with any of the journalists here in town.
Gotcha.
I have read the newspaper. According to this voice in my head,
we've heard that they
openly admitting
they kind of do some of the investigative work here in town. So I'm trying to see if we can find them and get some answers about how weird this
Maybe it would be good. Maybe it'd be good to have someone on the inside.
I mean, that's an idea.
So, are you all going to go to
the journalists or not? Are biased?
Are you going to go to the motel or to Zaron Beppoli's house?
Are you telling me?
To all of you.
There's anything at
first
the motel
of all,
that I actually
nobody
need.
Formally asked me to go to the motel, and I'm not really inclined to go there if something more interesting is going on. And also, this guy sounds rich, so
yeah.
He did give off an air of superiority that I could only assume comes from wealth. So
too eccentric than to anything else. House. Maybe he'll want to gamble again. That was fun.
Yeah, let's go to Zaron's.
Yeah, I'm here for the scoop, and the scoop is not back in my hotel room where I have been for the last 2 days talking to nobody, so and not doing my investigative job.
You definitely would have seen like the crime scene that we left behind, though.
Nope. Walked right by it.
Well, like, what's that over there?
Ignored the night guard that were standing there. You didn't give a shit.
Never mind.
So unless anybody is going to resist or cause problems, we can Batman over to Zaron's house. Yes. Because if I had to listen to y'all's conversation the whole way over there. Very good, very good.
Good job.
So you are in front of, what did I say, 18 Cobra Kai?
Yep.
18 Cobra Kai.
18 Cobra Kai.
That's what That is what you said.
That's what you said. I want everyone to know that the two main residential streets that we have seen so far are Big Avenue. And Cobra Kai.
Not Big even Ave. Cobra Avenue, dude.
Not Cobra even Cobra Kai. Cobra
Kai. Kai's the type Big of street Avenue. It is. On your way over, you do notice that the street is like snakes back and forth.
Like
it is just like curve after curve.
Is it like a cobra?
That is not for me to say. I'm just here to give you the facts.
You're just here to paint the cobra-shaped picture.
I believe we've hit the suburbs.
Yes, you do notice that this is, while Big Ave was in a nicer area with like the more Luigi's Mansion type houses, this one is in a poorer neighborhood with smaller, normal-sized houses.
Oh.
Not like dirt poor, you know, like.
But
like,
just a downgrade from Big Avenue.
Yeah, still like lower than middle, like still lower than middle class, but not like.
Okay. Zaron is leaving some on the table. It seems.
Either that, or he's not rich.
Or
and
he's not rich.
Yeah,
he could just be an interesting guy who wasn't rich.
Why didn't you consider that he wasn't rich first? So, this is a very frugal rich man.
He's a penny pincher, dude.
Avenue, Boulevard, Street, Rue, Strauss, Kai. Exactly.
100%.
Everyone knows Rue, Kai. Everyone
I feel like Rue is French, Strauss is German.
German.
Kai is all Cobra.
Kai is
Cobra.
10% Cobra.
I mean, it could just be a slurred Kai.
Shut up, Emily.
The fuck up.
It literally sounds the same as the first street in Spanish.
There's an extra syllable there in Spanish,
yeah,
kind of.
But in English, Kai, you know, we sort of put that extra syllable. It's a diphthong.
It's a diphthong.
It's a
diphthong.
It's a diphthong. You elongate the diphthong. You have two fucking syllables.
Is a funny
syllables.
Word. So
I definitely
fine.
Heard diphthong the last time that Emily said it, so.
Hey, if you want to get famous, definitely click that link, by the
Don't
way.
Click
if you're watching.
It's our first spam.
Super click that link. That link's going to be dope as hell. You should click the shit out of that.
What link?
I want to be
Do you want Ukrainian Sorry. Cyber criminals to know your information? Click on that link.
Emily, we're on something called Twitch right now. And there's
I like Dick Paul.
And there's a.
I'm not even.
Don't worry about it. Anyways, you find yourself on Cobra Kai.
I'm running 18.
I'm running right up to Zerone's abode.
Okay, you're at 18 Cobra Kai.
Run up and kick the door in.
That's what PT said.
Hello.
He said that out loud.
Do you knock on the door? Or you.
Hello. Why isn't anyone just
opening the door,
expecting me to be here at this very moment?
The door opens as soon as you start knocking.
Whoa.
And
it is. So he what?
It is Zerone Beverly. In his checkered hat. Checkered top
Monsieur.
Hat.
Monsieur.
Senor.
Look like, besides wearing a checkered hat. Oh,
what?
What's his deal?
Yeah, what's he look like?
Is he hot?
Or is he not?
Mine hair. Yeah, thank you.
He's got like a Salvador Dali look to him, I would say. Okay. He's got like the
So like half his face is melting and
Very highbrow, Emily. Very highbrow, thank you.
He's real swirly. Thank you, I know things.
You just bought yourself a swirly NPC, and that's not gonna be fun for anybody. That's how we got the orangutan kids. So.
NPC right before this match.
There's an NPC running around this world that's made of vomit, so we're kind of past.
And it's John's vomit.
And it's P.T. Sinclair's vomit.
P.T. Sinclair.
He's like.
Me and this guy already have like a mental, metaphysical link. To some extent, I tried to clairvoyance him once, and he was like, "No."
He was like, "Oh,
no."
So can I just
practice the mental arts?
Yeah, can I just like wink at him and like send him a little like, "Sup, clairvoyance, buddy."
He you feel him wink back at you in your mind's eye.
Guy's incredible.
Hello, I've been expecting your party. I didn't answer the door before because you hadn't knocked yet.
Were you waiting behind the door the whole time?
As everyone in town knows, it's incredibly rude to open the door before somebody's knocked.
I kind of look at everybody. Hello. Like, we'll keep that in mind. May we come in?
Are you vampires?
No.
We're just polite.
I pull the teeth back to show. No.
Yeah, that's nice. It's just a courtesy to bare your teeth to affirm that you are not a vampire.
Look, man, he asked if we were vampires from the jump. Like,
I'm all for it.
We just don't want to deal with that whole curfew thing, you know? Weird.
I would love to not get eaten.
Also, are there vampires here?
Sorry,
vampires exist. Are you on the record saying that vampires exist?
Sorry, that whole thing
vampires
was a
exist.
The whole thing was a bazinga. I'm sorry. Please come in.
Okay.
Please all come in.
Okay.
I go in.
I go in as well.
I do.
Please, you as well, ma'am. Please come in.
Is
if you'd like
no,
to,
Remy is still outside.
Yes? No, I'm going.
Everyone said they came in, and Remy just stood there.
Wonderful, wonderful. He closes the door behind you, and locks it.
What's his house look like?
It looks not lived. It looks not lived in.
Oh,
it's some of the furniture still has like the sheets over it. You're in the living room front door area right now.
My, this is a really nice, very, very new place.
So pristine.
It's not my home. You don't have to talk to me like that. I'm not a child.
Thank God. Okay. Right.
It's not a child. We thought you were a scary murderer. So I'm just so brought us to a house that isn't your house.
Funny that you mentioned murderers.
What
is it?
That's why.
Well, there's a lot of us here. You're gonna murder all of us.
I am a scary murderer.
Are you putting murderers in this house along with us?
Sounds like a lot of work.
No, today I'm here for cats and not mice. I need you to catch my murderer. He didn't murder me. He's been murdering other people.
I was going to say, we've been dealing with ghosts.
I was going to put a hand on him. I was going to touch him and be like, are you a ghost?
So wait, I've actually never murdered anybody.
Really?
I've also never murdered anybody.
Stop. We've murdered quite a few people, even before we got here. Like, come on.
Well, it's your word against mine.
Being innocent of murder is a very peculiar thing in this town.
All right.
It was so shocking. It froze her for a minute.
Yeah. She'll be back.
Oh, no! And, gotcha. And therefore, I have not killed anybody yet. Although, I don't really plan on killing anybody either, so...
It seemed like you were kind of threatening me, but we can walk right on past it.
I thought you were threatening me.
That I did talk about murderers.
It was ambiguous, and I just really didn't want to be murdered.
I understand.
We'll call it a wash.
I think we can all go this whole night without getting murdered, right?
Right. Are you looking at me? Yes. Yeah. Well, I mean, no. Okay. Not all of us. I mean, I brought you here because there is a murderer on this street somewhere.
Oh, okay.
So people are definitely...
Cobra Kai? Them?
What?
You need our help
on Cobra Kai?
Them?
Yes. On Cobra Kai this week, there is what they are calling the Cobra Kai killer.
You're promoing the show.
The Cobra Kai killer.
Cobra Kai killer.
Yes.
That's very fun.
Tell us what you know.
Yeah,
what's going on?
Yeah, I'll pull out my pen and paper.
Is there a lot of key hopping?
Key hopping.
Key hop!
I see now. I understand that now.
It's worse than I thought it was going to be.
is that how it's spelled? Is it key hop?
Oh, I don't like that.
I can't say. I haven't watched the murders myself. I just... There's a serial killer here.
Happening?
Yes.
How do you know?
Because people are dead. Because multiple people have been murdered.
That tracks. Hey, you know, good call.
That's correct. What
I'm with
an insight.
That.
Yes, the, well, so I thought it would be twofold for you. The Night Guard doesn't really investigate crimes in this neighborhood. They've marked their territory, and I would not go there right now. They're definitely after you all.
Yeah, they want our dick real bad.
Yes, you've made that very clear. They've made that very clear.
Oh.
Everyone's made it clear.
Yes, they are not happy about the horses either.
Yeah, I was going to say, luckily we slowed them down significantly.
I mean, killing horses is pretty not okay, guys.
The Kokomo thing.
Oh, the horses are still alive.
Yeah, it's a grotesque visage.
It's a lot. Don't worry about that. We didn't do anything to the horses.
We didn't do anything. I didn't pull the lever on the point on the acid.
They did it to themselves.
They acided a bunch of horses, and now there's a
acided for it.
There's a horrible tri horse monstrosity.
Acid.
I'm pretty sure he ate all of the children. By the way,
what?
Those kids were gross.
In the school that we left when we ran away from that, the Clydes, Chad, it was eating the Clydes children, presumably.
The town is having a complete complete to-do. He's definitely still in there.
I don't know why they set it loose in the school, okay? That's on them. I get having the Clydes, Chad, but they let it loose in the school.
Well, I think they were
trying... That's on them.
I assume they were trying to get you, and then I think getting a giant... triple horse monster into a building is a lot easier than getting him out. So,
like a cow up a staircase.
I think we have a cow on a staircase situation.
This was the Clyde's Chad was actually an elaborate senior prank. It was
senior prank gone wrong.
The equivalent of releasing three pigs labeled 1, 2, and 4.
Well, I think he ate all of the seniors, tremendous. So quite a prank indeed.
What a prank, yeah. Tell us about this murderer on Cobra. Tell us about the Cobra Kai killer.
Yeah, what do you know about the Cobra Kai?
I'd rather be told about your exploits, but I guess seeing as you guys are crazy murderers and I've been hanging out with you.
We're not crazy.
Scoop. We'll talk about it off camera.
I would
Robin
be careful with this group,
into the camera
young Scoop. You're about much more time with these few, and you're going to be caught up in it, Scoop. I'll tell you that. Anyways.
Sounds like it.
Let's say six dead. And.
Wow.
Yep. They're being.
Any through line between them? Any consistent behavior?
Yep. They're.
Trophies or.
Same modus operandi? What's.
They
what's
are.
Better?
Yep. This killer's been cutting them straight up from groin to face. Slices the skin right open, sucks them right out. Leaves the skin behind.
Oh.
Same looks like snake skin. Horrible.
Oh,
horrible.
That's actually good.
Yeah. Happened right where we're standing in this house.
So he's
horrible.
What?
This was house number one.
Wait.
Oh.
Wait, so we are already wanted for murder and you brought us to a crime scene?
Yes, I know that may seem peculiar.
Yes!
But I am aware of your past exploits. I felt it from both of you. And from you, young Scoop.
Are they at least, like, done looking at this house?
Well, that's no my point exactly. The Night Guard is not looking at these murders.
All right.
That's why I brought in your party to investigate this particular strand of murders.
So all the murders were on this street right here?
Yes. All on this street. Cobra Kai.
Normal street.
So how do you propose we go about investigating at night when the curfew is in place?
Oh, I would not go out after curfew.
Okay. Oh, I certainly wouldn't.
Do not do that.
God, no, please.
But you want us... Do you know the identity of the murderer?
I do not.
Okay. You want us to hunt down this murderer.
I am convinced...
Find out who they are and tell the authorities? Or...
Ooh, wouldn't do that either. They really, really love those horses.
Oh,
I cannot
okay.
stress that enough.
I do... Okay, sure.
Do not... Yes, I wouldn't go anywhere near the Night Guard.
Even during the day?
So, I am convinced that it is somebody who lives on the street. All of the murders have been on the street.
Really?
Yes.
But then if they killed everyone, they'd have to kill themselves at the end.
I'm a little worried that's the plan.
Zerone,
the street and then off themselves.
It's like eating eating the core of an apple. You just wipe that bitch right out of existence.
It's like apple never existed if you eat the core.
Are you positive that it is murder?
And not
because it sounds like it may just be a creature of some sort that is able to sort of put on a visage.
Was creating horrible snake creatures. Someone who is creating an army of horrible snake creatures that would be pretty good at combat.
I really just hope it's a serial killer now. Oh, I really just hope it's a guy with a knife.
Yeah, I really don't want to get peeled like a banana.
I prefer myself in my unpeeled state.
Maybe they should have called him the banana killer.
I really think the Cobra
man.
Kai killer
the banana peeler.
Banana man.
Than the banana peeler.
Banana man.
We must.
In fact, I think that's a.
The banana man.
We must hunt down
Mr. Banana
Grabber. Mr. Banana Man.
This is the banana man.
I think for the sake of discretion, internally, we should refer to him as the banana man.
I agree.
Wait,
yes.
So
you're absolutely right.
So are only the peels left of the people? There's no actual like fruit left, like their skeletons or
the
like
people fruit?
Yeah, like I'm using the banana. I have jumped with 2 feet into the banana metaphor, and you're giving me a look saying like it's a problem.
No, you're great.
I mean, I would say there's some
Robert, I love you and I always have.
There's some I would say there's some banana juice left around the room. Certainly a lot of that, but no, none of the core.
Okay,
we're talking all peels, no banana.
Okay,
oh, got it. Yucky.
Okay.
Okay.
It's so unfortunate.
Who was the victim here? And I'm gonna start kind of looking around and walking around the house if we're doing this.
Yes, I would like to investigate.
Yeah.
Yes.
I'm going into detective mode from like Batman, where he
PT Sinclair. Read my mind's eye. What was the name of the victim? Go now.
You can read it.
Harold Barkles.
Harold Barkles. That's exactly correct. It's an uncanny your abilities. Harold Barkles is victim number one. And what did we say? Six murders?
There were six murders.
Six
there
murders.
Have been six murders.
Starting with Harold Barkles.
Starting with Harold Barkles. I gotta write this down now because I'm gonna.
This is the Barkles residence.
This is the Barkles residence.
Yes, he lived alone. Some of the other homes were not as lucky.
He killed their houses too.
We look out into the neighborhood and there's just a house that's peeled away with nothing left.
So this is eight.
That's like called flipping out.
Cobra Kai.
Yes.
What are the other numbers?
Other numbers?
Of the houses.
Of the houses.
Yep.
Are they on the same side of the street or the other side of the street?
Well, interesting thing about house addresses.
Do you know the difference?
All the even numbers are on one side of the street and all the odds are on the other.
Wow, what
really?
That?
Yeah, that's like, for example, 111 Ave is actually next door to 113 Big Ave.
Fascinating.
The more that you know.
The more that you know. Legally distinct, sir.
So I believe the question was what addresses were these murders?
Yeah. Really weren't asking about the way
how those were.
Hit me with some numeros, mon frere.
I believe there should be five numbers from you.
Yep.
Unless multiple victims
yep.
were at one.
Here we go. Here's the five numbers. We're in murder number one, 18 Cobra Kai. Murder number two happened at 3 Cobra Kai.
Got it.
Now, that was actually three murders because it was
good
husband,
good.
Wife.
Efficient use of time.
So that
love
was two,
it.
Three,
oh,
and
that is,
four.
Did I? Yes, that's a huge coincidence that it's the address was three and there was three people murdered in it.
It's easy to remember, though.
Yes.
This banana man
total.
Surely.
Yeah, thankfully, that's not the case with the following houses.
Good.
Next house is 69 Cobra Kai. Nice.
Extremely
nice.
Good. Yes.
Nice.
This is a long street, by the way.
How many people were in that house?
One.
Okay.
Which brings us up to five of
five
these six
victims.
Murders, leaving one yes. house. Which is 37 Cobra Kai.
Cool. In the middle. Love that.
Okay, so no discernible pattern of how he's choosing the house.
All odd numbers except for the one we're currently
except
in.
For the one we're in.
I don't think that
all odd numbers.
For that.
I
mean, I feel like we could go check out three before curfew. How
yeah,
close are we to curfew?
But we're already in the one, and we haven't solved any murder
all
yet.
We know is it's Harold Barkles. We haven't learned any information, gleaned
right.
anything from the
okay,
Barkles
where,
house.
I'm trying to go
see the other places so I can try to find a through line between them.
We haven't looked for anything here yet.
All the ghosts.
We haven't found a knot to hold on to.
Your three ghosts pop out of the ghost bag.
Hey.
Gah!
Hey, you guys can
Woo!
You guys can help
guys
us
dead.
Out, right? What are you doing?
What are you doing?
Hey, just hanging out.
We're trying
out.
To solve a murder.
Yeah, that.
We're trying to solve
oh,
six
is it,
murders.
Is it ours?
Maybe. You guys live
next.
On Cobra Kai?
Did you live on Cobra Kai?
No.
Then no.
But,
okay.
Then
oh,
like it's your,
good to hear.
Your,
awesome.
Your lucky
thank
also,
you.
Also, shout out to you guys
to
being murdered
solve.
And you
oh,
not
you want
bringing
us
it
to
up.
Solve, you've never expressed this to us, that you want us to solve your murder.
Yeah.
You never said you were murdered. You.
You never asked.
Then what are you doing?
I'm sorry,
wait,
that's rude of me. I took a class
Wait, we did ask. We did ask
yeah,
how you were murdered. And you didn't say dick.
That's right. That's right.
We
did
ask
and you stonewalled
us. We asked you so
us.
Many questions. And you didn't answer a single one.
Don't talk to the little boy.
Yeah, Garbanzo here. Yeah, I mean, we didn't want you to talk to the little boy. That's weird. I think that's weird.
You were right there.
Okay, we get it. Go back in the bag. I got it. Go back in the bag.
No. I'm sorry. No hard feelings.
We want you around.
We do.
We just don't like the sass.
Gob is like, yeah, you hear that? She ain't got no hard feelings.
Gob, okay, we don't. Okay, Gob, we're never solving your murder. We'll solve
Garbanzo Tomahawks. You ghosts, as like being cool, you're excluded.
We'll solve Bucky's murder. You wish I was excluded.
Sure. We'll burn the rest of that jacket.
I'll murder all of you.
You won't. You're tiny. Yeah, look how big you are.
A little extreme.
I could fit you in an overhead compartment.
Yeah. You know, you can just.
Well, you can fit me in a bag. That's
you're not even half the man you used to be.
I feel like I'm exactly half the man I used to be.
Yeah. So, Beverly.
Yes.
Where did the murder happen? Take us to there. Take us to that place.
Yes.
Please.
Right here.
Like the peel was found here.
We found the peel right here.
Is there like a blood stain or anything?
In the foyer.
You must have an excellent carpet cleaner.
It's a wood flooring, and there is definitely like a darker stain, like where y'all are standing.
Okay. Oh, I step back immediately. Oh, God. Oh,
yeah. I touch it, and I cast clairvoyance.
See? Hard success.
Oh, rock hallelujah. Hard.
I needed under 58. I rolled a 27, which is a hard success.
Okay.
A success is hard.
That gave me a hard success.
As is PT Sinclair.
You know what I mean?
Okay. I just have to make a decision I didn't want to have to make quite yet.
Wait, while you have the time, let him vamp out his That's So Raven situation.
Yes.
I look down and I see the darker spot and I take both my hands and I place them down with just my fingertips all down. Don't look at me, Jorge. You gotta be thinking. I'm giving you time.
All he's doing is helping you.
I really hope it's another dolphin dream.
The dark spot becomes a puddle that I sort of somersault forward into. And as I'm diving forward into it, the camera flips yes. upside down, like Pirates of the Caribbean 3 style, and the upside down version
reference?
Is like you see the curve of me flipping, and
sorry,
on the other side.
Try to remember what happened in Pirates of the Caribbean.
Pirates of the Caribbean.
It does happen. He's correct. It does.
Or at World's End.
The other side, this is like the water line. You see me falling in, and then it turns, and then
I just remember.
You see me as a dolphin.
No.
Completing the turn. And then I eat some fish and have a great dolphin day.
What do you see?
Was that the lead up to the mission? Was that meant to transition
into a clairvoyant, like seeing the past, and you just
and
said you
I
had
saw.
A dolphin day.
What was the last bit? You were had trouble falling. You're a dolphin right now.
He's a dolphin right now.
He was like on the ship, passing, turning upside down, and then on the way back up, he became a dolphin.
He turned into a dolphin as the camera turned.
Yes, and on one of those.
Imagine me as Johnny Depp from Pirates of the Caribbean, all of them. And instead of going from being in Davy Jones' locker to being alive, I go from being P.T. Sinclair to being a dolphin.
Yes. So on the last one of you as a dolphin diving back into the water.
Yep.
When you dive out, it's out of the pool that is the dark spot in the room that you had jumped into because your vision is about the room that you were already in. And you jump out, and then you're a dolphin dried up on the ground next to it, flopping around. And it's like from there, as you're flopping, you're seeing the scene play out. And it's a It's a person in, you recognize one of the robes from the meeting that you were at.
Ooh.
And they've just finished, like you can tell they had their foot down on the skin and they've like just finished yanking the last of the banana out of the peel. This is how we're talking about it.
Yeah. They've but just then, completed peeling the banana.
Yeah.
Instead of being people.
They stop what they're doing all of a sudden and then turn over to you and look directly at you as you're still like flopping around on the ground. And they're like, I suspect a psychic. And they come over to like grab you, but then you wake up on the ground in front of everybody else and you're still like flopping.
My God, PT.
Uh-oh.
That's, everybody else just saw him drop to the ground and flop that on.
That must have been really weird for them at the time.
Yeah,
it makes
you did
a
get
lot
a
of sense.
You did get a little of him trying
right
to like.
Yeah, we saw what he was going for, but it wasn't working.
PT starts to do the worm, and it's really bad, and everyone's confused. And
no one will like this if you try to do it as a dance move.
Yes, but I think...
I don't intend on it, Robert!
Are you okay?
No, never.
And that's where we'll leave it for this week.
Okay.
That's pretty good.
Yes, so I don't know. I can't get you another to another cliffhanger in 5 minutes.
Real quick cliffhanger.
Super.
Oh, Baggy shows up again and kills her.
Taylor wasn't here, and it's the only opportunity I had to get Baggy in and out as quick as possible. I just, because everything you see in this game is vulnerable to being killed, by the way. There is nothing that is just going to come railroad you guys. So if I want something recurring, I need to get them in and out as fast as possible.
As soon as possible.
Which means I need to make sure Taylor's not looking and they need to come kick you in the nuts and run away.
Oh, shit. Yeah, wait. Can I, like, I want to... Can PT have, like, asked for a phone and, like, called the bar and left a message for Conrad?
We can do that during this. I assume that y'all are going to have to spend the night in this house.
Exactly. Yeah.
During that time.
I just wanted to know where we are.
Yeah.
So we are at 18 Cobra Kai.
Cobra Kai.
We're at 18 Cobra Kai.
And that's the show. If
that's it.
You would like to see more of me and Brian and Taylor, who is not here, but you know him, then you can find that at our podcast, Brian.
You can find that. You can go to our website, which is r-we-friends.com.
.com. I literally made it. I don't think I've ever said the address.
Or you can go on our Instagram or Twitter, which is @_arewefriends, all one word. Where can we find...
Next.
The Emily and John.
You can find us. Well, I live in Northern Virginia.
Wait, no, so don't.
Okay.
My address is, my credit card number
my
is.
My social security number is. So Emily and I have a podcast. It's called Downtime with John and Emily. And you can find that at getdowny.com. Or you can just follow us on wherever you get podcasts. Just search Downtime with John and Emily and subscribe to us. Follow us there. You can also find us on Instagram and Twitter at Downey Siblings. That's that. We would like to thank for this show.
Yes. Thank you.
If you liked the music that you heard at the beginning of the episode, by Ethan Gustafson. You can find more work from Ethan at somepointsound.com.
.com.
Nice. There's also a link to one of his social, I think it's Instagram, on our Twitch profile. Also, if you liked the graphic art that you saw, that's done by my friend Joe. He goes by Wormtongue on Instagram, and you can find his Instagram link on our profile as well.
And Shannon?
You can find me at Sharon and Blarnin on Instagram. I've I've dabbled with downtime. I've hung with the Are We Friends guys. It's a great time. Please listen and subscribe wherever you get your podcasts. But also, please join us here again next Thursday at 7 p.m. Eastern Time, right here at twitch.tv/theOutlawsNetwork.
Yeah, so next week, the episode will be playing, but we'll not be playing it live. We'll be doing a live recording of it earlier in the week. So
either this weekend
that
or
means you get to watch the stream of it twice. Live.
You have to. Do
not
it.
Really.
Please. Tell all your friends about this and have them follow it.
Well, unless there's anything else, I have been your keeper, Jorge.
I've been Shannon as Remy McSquemmy.
I have been Brian as Robin Renard.
I've been John as the world famous P.T. Sinclair.
And I've been Emily as Scoop McCutcheon. Thanks again for having me on, guys.
Thank you.
Of course. Woo! Thanks for watching.
NP.
Bye.
See you later, fuckers.